Talking about toxic food, what they don't want you to know. So again, in my own opinion, when we're talking about some of the vegetarian meat substitute foods and fake meats, as I call them, that are out there, they unfortunately can be very high in toxins. And one of those toxins that is known and has actually been tested in some of these fake meats is glyphosate. So I have an entire show all on glyphosate. So please do check it out if you don't know what glyphosate is and some of the problems that it poses for our human digestive tract and our overall immunity. So that's really important that we know about that and try to avoid glyphosate at every turn. Now, in this sample, so this was actually tested in, and I won't mention the name brands of the meat substitutes in their burgers, in terms of the glyphosate toxicity and the levels, it was actually quite high. And I was surprised to see these types of numbers in something that should be a, you know, or is touted as a health food in terms of meat alternatives, but definitely is not because of that glyphosate. And that's just one of the issues that I have with fake meat and going to that type of food instead of eating, you know, the real food itself. Now, another thing that can happen in terms of, and what they don't want you to know, is some of the things that are actually added to foods. So this is, again, often touted as health foods. The low fat types of foods often will have gums and gels and something called carrageenan to help with the consistency of these foods, and often the low-fat foods, usually it's dairy products, but other foods can certainly have these added ingredients and these fillers, and it's something that can be, again, very inflammatory to your gut, and a lot of people do have side effects from, and they don't know that it's related to these food fillers. That is, again, not something that's natural, and these are always synthetically made. Now, another issue that you, if you've watched me for years and you know that I speak a lot about on television, is the difference between synthetic vitamins, so fake vitamins, versus whole food real vitamins. And that's something that definitely I've got other videos on. You can certainly enlighten yourself if you've ever joined one of my live sessions. You know that I talk and educate people about the difference between getting your nutrients from foods and from, if it is going to be a vitamin, it should be a whole food vitamin without any of the other fillers and things. So whether it's silicon dioxide is a filler in vitamins, titanium dioxide, another filler, magnesium stearate. You really have to check your supplement bottles, your vitamin bottles, to ensure that you're not ingesting some of these fillers that are contained in most of the supplements in the marketplace. So today I talked about all of, you know, my opinions on some of the fillers and the fake ingredients and the toxicity issues with some of the foods that are out there in the marketplace that are often touted as health foods, and really, in my opinion, they are far from healthy. I hope you've got some questions or comments. What would you add to the list of fake foods and unhealthy things? Please put it in the comment section below. Be sure to share this video as well and give me a big thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, welcome in. I hope that you'll subscribe and turn on those post notifications by clicking that bell. Everyone does have a calling in life, and mine is to empower you to live a healthy lifestyle and, of course, to do it naturally. Thanks for watching.